Okay, looks good.
All right.
We are getting some drop frames, but I don't know how to fix that on my end.
Well, if you're having issues there in the
It's
live
back.
stream of the Twitch land, apologies. We're trying to make it work through the troubling times of broken internets. All right, you make your way to Fort Servius. While at Fort, when you get there, they are on.
That second day, Chagga sends us that like while we're force marching, we get the hour rest, get our
Okay.
spells back. The first thing that Chagga does, so it's 1 hour and 10 minutes, is
Okay.
cast the sending.
All right.
Nice.
With the sending response.
And then, let me read the sending. General, yesterday morning, goblins attacked our camp. Squad slew 1350. Scouted Phaenfar, over 10,000 now there, pouring through tower. Returning to Fort Manius, intelligence, Chaga.
If you could send a soundtrack with this ending. Dun, 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 dun. Soundtrack sending.
Probably one of the most iconic tracks, and it's on the list.
And then I think at that time we're also going to get Dassod to do the Chaga interrogate, where Chaga just asks questions while Dassod is in its mind.
Yeah. Take a break for like 20 minutes to do that.
Good work. Return with haste. No word from Lieutenant. Troubles brewing. Be safe. All hail the Undying Emperor.
Every sending those five words.
Did you understand trouble's already here?
Chaga relates to his sergeants what she said. It appears that the general has not disagreed with us returning to Fort Manius. Apparently, our lieutenant has not fared very well teleporting to what was it called, Fort Crag.
Yeah. First rule, teleport. Make sure you got another one.
Yes, don't worry, I'll learn teleport soon, and then you can trust me.
He comes up real close to Chaga, his arm around him. Don't worry, buddy, I trust you. Do you trust me?
About as far as I can throw you.
Good thing I'm heavy.
Chaga just grabs you by the waist and picks you up, because Chaga with muleback cords is actually pretty strong.
Whoa! Guess we got a lot of trust in this party.
No, I don't have my spells back yet though, because I need 8 hours sleep.
I have a question about the whole trust thing. If you can only trust them as far as you can throw them, don't you want to be really small like Dugan so you can throw them a really long way?
Nah, I'm super trustworthy.
I don't think that
You are.
I don't think that saying translates well into Fae.
See, if I wanted to show Dugan how much I trusted him, I'd tie him to an arrow, cast True Strike, and shoot him a long way.
Dugan, happy to say we lost your punishment ball when we lost the wagon.
That is a pity. So comfortable with that thing.
I'm pretty certain they kept the plans. We can get them to make a new one if you need.
I trusted him
I'm
when he
pretty
was.
certain bowstrings are pretty fragile.
I trusted him when he was in the sphere.
And we could throw the sphere a long way.
Yes, I'll one day know telekinesis as well. One day. Teleport first, though. I think I finally figured it out. Don't worry, I'm not going to experiment on any of you. All right, the general has told us to return. Let us continue. Oh, well, first, let's slip into the mind of our friend here.
Yeah, let's do that.
You want me to go back
Oh,
to
he's
your.
coming too. There we go.
It's 60 miles between Fort Servius and Fort Manius, so it's.
Yep. Are you following the roads, or no, are you going direct?
This is the day before we got to Fort Servius. We're going to interrogate the orc.
Okay, sorry, so you're basically at Mangrove.
Yeah.
All right. Sorry, that's this the obligatory sound when we move the duck token.
Some sort of error here.
All right.
If you wouldn't mind, Kev.
Yeah, sure. No problem. Unexpected error. Just all right. Well, apparently still good now. Kev's going to do his thing and slip into this guy's mind.
Okay.
With this guy, what we're going to do is probably take a stick, put it behind his back and tie his hands so that they're separate, and put like wrap his fingers up so that he can't cast. I know he's... alchemist, but I don't know, one of these fuckers running off or teleporting away or some shit. Making it really hard for this guy to do anything with his hands, basically.
Okay. How much time are you spending tying him up?
10 minutes.
10 minutes? Okay. So while Chagga was getting his sending going, you're tying up the guy that you've been... You've only been... having Doug peck him in the head for 2 days, so, or a little bit over a day and a half.
Yeah.
Can I try, if we're going to keep this guy alive, can I try something? We're not going to hurt him, right?
No, there's no need.
Okay, if you tell me what to ask him, I can make him my friend.
Sure, you can do that while I'm in his mind, it's fine.
He might be a little less guarded that way.
Dee Dee's gonna fly forward and blow a bunch of pixie dust into his nostrils. She will spend 5 doses of her pixie dust that day on charm.
Okay, now the DC if I remember. Go ahead.
DC's 23.
If I remember correctly, alchemists are famously known for shitty will saves.
That they are.
It's like being a caster class. You know what I mean?
The charm's only gonna really last. The charm's only gonna last for 10 minutes. So let's get this moving.
Out of curiosity, well, Kev's in there and she blows the stuff in his face. What happens to Kev?
Do you want to? You can go snort some pixie dust if you want.
No, he's still in his mind, and she did this.
Okay.
Kind of like, ooh, let's see what happens.
All right, so you blew a bunch of doses into his face. Kev, you're in his mind. He's also unconscious when the pixie dust was applied, so.
Yep.
All right. He is...
Chuck is writing some things down and showing it to Dee Dee.
He's thinking about, like, a green flame. That's what he's dreaming about.
Dee Dee, ask him about the green flame.
Okay.
You got time.
Who's waking him up?
Dee Dee will.
Okay.
With the agreement that we're not torturing him, we're just going to use Fey Tricks to get...
We're just going to use Fey Tricks to do the job.
Yep.
Okay.
Hi. You can call me Dee. I'm Sunny, and I'm your friend.
What is your... What language are you speaking?
She will speak in... Goblin. Nope, she learned that this language. This level. She's speaking in Imperial Common.
Do you understand me?
Korchka.
Dassod starts translating.
Yeah, this is my translator, Kev. You can call him K. Special K.
Can I stay in his mind and still...
You can, as long as you don't take a standard... Or like
a standard action.
You need to spend 1 action per round concentrating.
Okay.
Cool.
I'm your friend, and if you talk to me, you won't die. Okay? We'll try to maybe, keep you alive. You'll get good treatment. You can trust me. You can trust any D.
Yeah, Kev's. Can you give him a bit of food?
There you go. What's the green flame? I've been hearing lots of chatter about that.
Green flame. Mm-hmm. He's looking distrustful of those around that are not Dee Dee and okay. questioning yeah,
you,
of...
You guys stand back. You guys stand back. The interpreter is okay.
Can I diplomacy to try to... Like, hey, food, blah, 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 I speak your language.
Your diplomacy is quite good. Like, we're basically... Other people basically have to not stand there and look threatening. So, like, Sulfur's climbing a tree. Capra's going to go give some space.
Chagga's writing questions on, like, a piece of paper that he's holding up where the Hobb can't see.
Heart of Nefexi. Ultimate alchemy.
All right, I'm going to write this shit down.
Ever-melting fire of acid.
Heart of what? Say the name again.
Nefexi.
That's a PH name, is
it? It's a PH name. It's an ostentatious PH name.
Marnie, are you taking this?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, we heard about Nefexi. The mighty Nefexi. She serves Ironwalker as Aersi, right?
Yes.
Or is it the other way around? Does Aersi serve Nefexi?
It is complicated. It is. He's trying to like motion with his hand. He's like struggling to.
Oh, yeah. Here, let me help you. Let me help you, buddy. Let me help you. And he's, and Kev is undoing one of his hands.
He's two heads butting together.
Oh, okay, so they're like co-workers. Got it. Lovers?
No.
But they're the same rank.
Mighty Nefexi, very mighty. Mighty Nefexi. Atlantia.
Ask him where he's from, too.
Mighty Nefexi. Atlantia. Ironwalker Atlantia. Mighty Nefexi. And he's kind of motioning like...
Okay. Is Dassod getting... Dee Dee looks at Dassod.
You getting any of this?
Is Dassod getting a clearer picture than the broken I don't speak common speech?
Yes. He is basically putting the Iron Walker above the mighty Nefexi.
Okay.
And this other thing that he described, he used the term Atlantia. He doesn't know what Atlantia is, but he knows that it is, like, the Iron Walker would be like Atlantia. And it's something that is more than the Nefexi, but he is very adamant of, like, he's devoted to this Nefexi.
Got it. So Iron Walker, Atlantia, Nefexi is the order of the...
Yeah, he drew a parallel between Iron Walker and Atlantia. Like, in his mind, those are, like, at the same level.
All right, and then Nefexi's below?
And Nefexi is below. But he is a follower of Nefexi.
Okay. Okay. So, how does the Iron Tower work? Where'd you come from?
Walk through Great Hall of Iron. And then he kind of looks a little bit at... He's speaking, like Kevin's translating, but he's speaking to Dee Dee. Follow Great Hall, and then go in tower, follow Great Hall, come out tower.
Where's the Great Hall located? Sounds like it's far away.
In tower.
Oh.
And tower, tower very small.
Where did you come from? Before you went into the Great Hall, before you went into the tower? Are you on Volcanica, or were you on...
Could you quickly go over to the world map? I forgot to get the name. Apologies. Vankorkot.
Can you say that again?
Vankorkot.
Vankorkot.
Knowledge geography?
20.
20. There's a city called Vankor.
Sorry.
It's an island.
Oh, okay. Okay. That's where you're from? And then you walked into the Great Hall and came through the tower?
Great Hall in Lost City.
Oh.
My people, Vankorvok.
Where's the Lost City?
Vipers. City of Viper. Snake City.
Okay, so you came from Vankor, and then... okay. And then you went to the Lost City of Vipers.
Iron Tower bring many goblin, many face, many tribe.
Is the Lost City the only way into the Iron Tower, or are there other ways in? Are there other Iron Tower in different places? Yeah.
It has a hall, more than one long hall.
Oh, how many long halls?
Make an int check for the guy. He's an alchemist and he rolled really well. Give me 1 second.
Yeah, you're a good boy. You have a cracker.
ask him who controls the tower so I can get a picture of him. And share that with Chagga later.
Yep.
Believe the answer, he says, 6 halls is what he says.
Huh. And each of these halls goes to a different place. One of the halls goes to Phaenfar.
They guide. They say which hall to go.
There's a guide. Okay.
Does he give us a picture of the, like, do I see any important people? I'd keep oh, that guy.
He has this veneration for a very, very large dragon, a very large old dragon. Give me a heal check and or nature check and or arcane check.
Okay.
Okay.
Heal, arcane, nature. Right, so if I don't have any of those, now I have one.
Then you roll an int check.
It's not impressive, but it's impressive. Natural 20, goddammit, I'm awesome. Stream's down. On my side, it's down. I'm refreshing.
Still running for me.
Sorry, then keep going. I'll refresh again.
Okay, I've lost my train of thought. What did you get on your total on your check there?
Nat 20, 27 for the heal check on the dragon. The old dragon.
If you're not familiar with dragons, this dragon's scales are turning white and crusty.
I'm going to share memories with Dee Dee, get her to draw this.
Yeah, we'll do that later.
Okay, different line of questioning. Who's King Parthuk?
No, Parthuk.
You were off to go You're about to serve him on behalf of Ironwalker Azersi, according to this scroll.
Troll. Spits.
A troll king. Okay. Lovely. And who's Prince Ibzeriak?
Suitor. Suitor to... Suitor to great Nefexi.
Ah, a love interest. Okay, fine. Now we're talking. Okay. Is he handsome?
Nefexi seeks mate.
Is he handsome?
Don't know.
What? What? Is Nefexi a hobgoblin like you?
Nefexi, great beast, talents, wing. He's imagining a dragon. He hasn't seen it, so you can tell from like what he's thinking. He's filling in the blanks of what Nefexi would be. But he's imagining a powerful, ferocious, slightly... Fabio-looking dragon. Like, this is what his mental image would be.
All right, and is Nefexi the old crusty dragon?
Nefexi's the old crusty dragon.
Oh, okay. That's nice. Oh, I wish Agony was here. He knows about dragons. Well, kinda. But, yeah, okay. Here you go, boy. I think that's it for now.
You ask him who runs the tower.
Well, yeah, is it Ironwalker Azeris that runs the tower, or is it Nefexi, or is it something even badder or bigger?
If he knows how he runs it, that would be even better. Maybe that key they were talking about.
Yeah, is there an artifact, the Iron Key, Dacheron? Who's got that? Bosses everyone around. Opens up the doors.
Azarsi.
Azarsi. Okay.
Scarvinius. Scarvinius.
Who's Scarvinius?
Yeah, does he have an image for that?
Scarvinius, he's a you see him, like, he's thinking about a powerful bugbear with sort of kind of invisible, with blood spraying all over the place. You don't think he's interacted with Scarvinius much, because he's, again, sort of filling in a bunch of blanks.
Okay, yeah. Can you carefully put him back to sleep, please?
He's snarling at Mort.
Hold on, Dee Dee. One sec. Hold on, Mort. Dee Dee, would you just...
Yeah, it's wearing off, and we'll do that later.
No, I mean the sleepy stuff.
Yeah.
And then...
Okay, she sprinkles some dust on a cracker. Eat this!
You'll eat the cracker.
It's all good. You go to sleep. It's okay. Yeah,
he goes to sleep.
Okay.
Right, now we knock him the fuck out.
Drop
him. Kick into a tree.
Okay, so it sounds like you need to write a report.
Actually, if we can get Lloes to share memories with you, you can draw the stuff. But yeah, I have a lot of shit to write.
Oh, that sounds like fun, maybe?
Yeah, there's a dragon, a bugbear.
Maybe when you guys are done walking back to the fort, we can do all that.
Yeah. Does my memory of this degrade? Or, like, is it...
So, the spell allows you to get surface thoughts. So you don't... The images you're getting are, like, conceptual images.
That's right.
They're not going to be good for, like, scrying or teleporting.
Yeah, when I say the word Ahmed, I'm not summoning a high def image of Ahmed.
Right.
Definitely not in that pose, dude.
Like child representation where the people look like spiders, where there's like only key features. Yeah. They had a big nose and they had ears and there was a face and then like everything else kind of fades away. But yeah, you could definitely do artist renditions of things. It's just how accurate they'll be is
okay. Quite. So on the way there, I guess I'll start jotting. Let me know when to roll for it and I'll roll for it.
Okay.
The report, that is.
So when you make the rest of your way to Fort Servius, you've basically made yourself from Mangrove to Fort Servius. You do meet the goblins. The goblins give you food and they hail the Chamek tribe.
Okay. Chaga will give them instructions to check for shape changers with any new members and we'll teach them the hair trick.
Okay.
That hair will turn into a different
Won't change the blood.
Yep.
Won't the blood as well? Their blood color?
The Barghast blood was too similar to the goblins, so that's why we need to do the hair trick. And then if the goblin doesn't have hair, then take a tiny bit of flesh, like peel some skin or something like that.
Okay. All right. So you've made your way to Fort Servius.
Nice.
You've got some information. What are you doing with your prisoner?
We're bringing them all the way to Fort Manius. We check in with Fort Servius, and
okay.
Is there somebody in charge of Fort Servius?
Yes, there is. If we go back,
do you want me to switch back or?
Yeah, we can switch back. There's only one other question about which path are you taking to Fort Manius? Are you taking the roads or are you trying to cut across trail?
The roads.
Taking the roads.
I think it'll be faster. More likely chance of bullshit, but we are adventurers.
Okay. So just give me a second. I will. On to.
Servius or Manius? Are we at Servius right now?
Servius.
Okay.
So you do meet, like, this. The Commandant Cicero is basically interested in your personages, as you've come from the front, and he's heard whispers of that there might have been violence and or things, and that you've returned way quicker than you were supposed to, or than what was thought.
Okay.
Or presumed.
Does he stop us, or?
He basically, you are stopped for a total of, well, do you stay there to rest?
Mm-hmm.
As you've been force marching the whole way?
Yep.
Okay.
Can they give us a cart and horses?
You can attempt to requisition things with which to travel more smoothly. Are you going to do this through lie, cheat, steal? Are you going to do this through military channels? How would you like to handle grabbing some things?
I can help with diplomacy and try to do it through the military.
Okay, so you're going to ask for favors.
Yeah, like here, we went through a ton of crap. And here's some info, blah, blah, blah. Diplomacy? Or what would you like me to roll?
Roll a diplomacy.
Okay.
Kev is out bartering. And are you taking your prisoner with you, or did you lose your prisoner along the way?
We are taking our prisoner with us.
Here, yeah. Let me grab 33. The prisoner.
33 on the diplomacy.
Okay. Yeah, you're able to requisition a wagon and some horses. It is an ammo cart. The horses are strong and young. They're not as pretty as Chaga's horses were. And you, there's you, the commandant asks, the commandant is a young man. He seems quite battle ready, battle hardened. But he is somewhat young for his current position. He wonders if you want the prisoner, as he sees you have a prisoner, if you want him to be thrown in the dungeon.
No, this prisoner is going directly to the dungeons of the general. What was his name? Commandant? Sorry, the map's still loading, so apparently there are tokens added. So,
Cicero.
Commandant Cicero, you should know that Phaenfar is completely overrun with hobgoblins and goblins, not to mention shape-changing outsiders and Oni. It was completely compromised when we arrived. We could teach you the tricks to check your populace to see who is a shape-changer. If you would like, I suggest you do this immediately.
Okay, you show him the Oni heads.
Yep. There are these things that are masquerading as people, as well as these goblin dog things called bar guests.
I'm familiar.
Well then, know that the town was completely overrun, and,
three that were heading here.
Not even 24 hours after us arriving, the town was overrun by goblins. Thousands of them began to pour through a gate. There are at least 10,000 that are there now, if not more, including giants and other creatures. You should man your walls.
Give me a charisma check, an intimidate check, a a professional soldier check, a diplomacy check.
Can
purveying serious information in a serious manner with which to be respected.
Can Dassod help, or
I certainly can.
Does Chagga want Dassod to lead it?
Nope, Chaga's.
Chagga was talking, so
I auto aid.
You aid.
Yes.
And you can get a +4 bonus because he knows of some of the creatures with which you speak, so he's familiar with the concept.
25.
And you have a bag of heads, so that's +2/+2.
We managed to kill in several skirmishes. We would like to put in the official registrar. The sack of Phaenfar, we managed to kill 300 goblin warriors, one yellow-faced Oni, and two lesser bar guests. In the Forest Road skirmish the next day, 54 Hobb infantry and beast handlers, and not but two mornings ago, I think the Forest Road Massacre might be a good name for it. We killed 1,358 hobgoblin and goblin warriors, heavy infantry, wolf riders, and arcane hunters. If you do not believe me, we can use a spell to share some of the moments of the battle. We also could... We'll verify this information when we hand over our prisoner to the general.
Might I see your hand?
Takes off the glove and he gives them the hand with the the Foreign Legion.
He looks at it. I would accept such a spell.
All right. In order for me to conjure this, it must come through a spirit that is bound to me. Don't worry, he's very friendly.
Okay, he's going to wave a couple of guards over. He's got a few more soldiers around him.
Lloes, come out. Please don't come out with your sword. We're amongst humans. They think you're very interesting. Hi there!
Greetings.
Lloes, if you could share memories of, say, as we were pushing our final victory... In the last few moments of the battle, as we were facing down those horrible alchemists. Yeah, when they firebombed all of your ice walls.
Yes,
maybe just a few minute block in there. Sure. And he's going to, from Lloes's perspective, share the memory with the commander. Lloes is off to the side fighting goblins and then looking at what things are going on.
He's got this scene of... He also gets to see the, I'm the greatest swordsman ever! And he's like, ching, ching, ching!
Right.
So somebody who's like, if they value honor at their core, the ghost dueling people who can't possibly harm the ghost is a little bit of like, but understood, Sergeant.
So he's sharing a minute of the battle. He'll cast a couple, two or three of them to get little chunks of the battle. Like when Chagga and the others are casting spells. And
The whole battle was a minute and a half.
Okay, so two spells gets the entire...
The whole, like, from, like, from Mork going, oh, we fucked up! up to the point where you're just chasing down the stranglers. Yeah.
So you get a lot of Lloes going into the ground and popping out and attacking things. Yep. But the corpses.
Well, the corpses, you see fire raining, like, just explosions, tactics.
Chagga just leans on his, like, he's got his, like, necromantic scepter as sort of like a walking stick, and he's leaning heavily on it and just waiting.
Understood, Wayfinder.
Lloes, you can retire to your vessel.
Lloes gives him a wink and a little smile, and then looks back at the commandant and flows into his vessel.
The ammo wagon that you're provided has two kegs of gunpowder just sort of loaded in as just
being, yep,
just in case.
Yeah, Kev's happy.
Very well. I think Jex and Keg and Dassod probably are filling up their powder horns, right?
Yep. Ride safe in the morn.
Good luck to you. Just for our own edification, do you have enough men here to take on 10,000 goblins and hobgoblins?
No, we do not.
So what happens if they march down this road?
We hold the fort.
It'll take them a day or so to get here if they decide to march.
All hail the Undying Emperor.
All hail the Undying Emperor.
Good luck to you, Commandant. If you don't mind a lowly sergeant saying.
The sod's taking one of the keg, puts it back. You're gonna fucking need this.
Yeah, we give them, after filling our powder horns, I think we're gonna give them the kegs back. Oh, and we'll give them the weird trebuchet, like, that will show them what the goblins were using to throw horrible fire. If you see any goblins using this, with all due prejudice, destroy that group of goblins. These are alchemists. We watch them melt a church with their battlefield tactics.
The Horde.
Perhaps
with all due haste.
Perhaps pretty damn calm about this.
Perhaps we'll return, but it's really in the general's. We have orders to return to the general's side with our intelligence and prisoner.
Understood. I will have a letter prepared for the morn.
No, we had a really easy time fighting them when they were on a road. Just so you know.
I am aware.
All right. Just a sergeant after all here.
He saw the battle.
Oh, look at that shit.
That is so awesome. That is not a common spell. That is so great.
So, you don't believe me, huh? Spirit.
All right, so you are given a sealed letter and are asked to hand this or to give this to the general.
Okay.
You suspect strongly it's a request for reinforcement.
Yeah, after what we just told them.
He has a couple hundred men.
Not enough.
So against 1,000 goblins, they should have been okay with walls and that sort of advantage. 10,000? No. That is too much for his defense.
No cannons?
Oh, he has cannons. They have cannons. You are fed, clothed, you're given their fastest horses and a decent wagon. Sorry. They keep their fastest horses for the emergency messenger. They give you the second fastest horses.
That's fine. These horses, their only purpose is to bring us to the next fort, which is 60 miles away through Forest Road. Yep. So we go.
Okay. You basically, well, there's a very low chance of a of encounter in this region. Ahmed, since you're the lucky one, let's see if we can roll another like 8 of
1d20 bar guests.
Okay, I finally was able to load Servius. So where's the
interesting, because I didn't add any new tokens. Like I added 47. One token since that was before, like during the pregame. Yeah, coming at
47 at him.
Okay, 47. Okay, you aside from a couple of minor bits of bramble, there are no issues in the travel. Nice. You make your way to Fort Manius. At Fort Manius, they're already on high alert. Fort Severus was on high alert by the time you.
Nice. We march all the way up to the fortress and report directly to the general.
Kate?
I don't see our tokens on Fort Manius.
Oh, sorry. Give me a second. I'll grab them.
And Mark looks like he's fatigued. Oh. Mark has the fatigue condition.
Shut up!
Mort has the grumpy condition. I'm assuming that Mort doesn't travel as large when he doesn't need to.
Yes, he does, because he's actually faster that way. Okay. Mind you, he could still keep up with Chagga, I guess.
All right.
You run a cart.
At the fort at this point in time.
Dugan, would you like to come with us?
All right, fine. Why?
Well, we're going to hand over some of our magical goods.
We got the best eye for this shit. Come on.
All right. Yeah, I wouldn't mind seeing where they store this stuff.
Chagga smiles. No, just look. Don't touch.
Oh, yeah, I gotcha. Yeah. Wink.
No. The things that we found are of little consequence. We don't want to shoot our gun too early.
I gotcha. Save it for later. Okay.
Remember, you owe me a web.
Besides, Chagga jingles his pouch. Chuck has already moved the box of gems with the 5,000 gold pieces into a pouch that is not going into the assessor's hands.
Yep.
Prove it.
It was in the memory.
Yeah, we might have lost those memories. Yeah, that, no, I think that box came from.
That box came from the dwarves, the Phaenfar trading company.
Yeah, we're definitely new rule. We're not going to share memories of looting.
Unless, like, as you kill a goblin, coins fly the fuck up in the air.
Yep. All right, so Chaga's got Duckin on a leash because it's funny. He's going to order Kev to move the alchemist with us, and he's going to bring his other sergeant, I guess, Capra.
Yeah, we'll have him on the shoulder.
So before you're allowed in the gates, each of you have to submit to getting your tattoo inspected.
Yep.
After your tattoo is inspected, they allow you in.
The others that are left behind are being ordered to just kind of get our gear together. I've already sorted the treasure for inspection, basically. There's a bunch of categories in the treasure sheet that are highlighted for review.
Okay. How are you describing your prisoner? Because they're basically doing the same prisoner. Shall we throw him in the dungeons?
No, I'd rather keep him with us. He is of great importance to the Empire. He has memories and knowledge of our enemy's artifacts. I'm not going to leave him from my sight. No offense.
Chagga
looks at whatever rank.
The general was very interested in the information that we were providing, and I'm sure that she would be very happy to see him right away, trying to help with diplomacies.
Okay, you outrank this man. You're talking to a corporal.
Okay.
What he ends up doing is assigning four men to guard your prisoner. So you've got four dudes following you around.
Cool.
Okay. Are they all privates? Or are they corporals?
There's one corporal and three privates.
All right.
You're still in charge.
Let's go.
Okay.
Like a bunch of badasses returning from the field.
I don't know, but I've been told we leave goblins on the road.
It's pretty good there. Pretty good.
I believe they call this the swagger.
Right, job well done, guys.
Okay, so you are marching into the war room, or where are you headed?
We'll find out where the general is, and we'll go see her.
Basically going, I'm going to see the general. And this was a lot easier than the last time. So, yeah, you know where to go. You go through a few checks. They look at the hob that you're dragging with you. He gets inspected a few times. They check, like, at least one person's checking to make sure he's knocked out.
We'll send the Imperial, one of the Imperial soldiers, the one that looks like a private in that group, to go fetch you a proper set of manacles.
Okay. Yep, they comes back. They shackle him, wrists and ankles.
Okay.
He nods.
Are you private with the thing and the good job?
If we can get a sec here, if no mouth comes to chat with me, what are we talking about here? Because I don't think I can keep the tower away from him.
Where's Lloes?
Probably on your undead.
Did you leave Lloes behind?
No.
Did I leave Lloes?
Chagga's
got Lloes. Tell him to get his own fucking key. It's that important.
Yeah, I don't see the Lloes.
Lloes, I didn't leave him on the other map.
Oh, there he is. He was under Grackle.
Okay.
Chaga's got the backpack.
Perfect. All right.
The share memory spell is almost a spell I think Chaga's going to take. It's too...
It's a good one.
It's too good.
I call bullshit. I call bullshit on your bullshit. Here you go. Where you get fun is you get somebody, you modify your own memory so that when you share your memory, you're sharing the modified memory.
Yes.
Oh, that's sad. The Machiavellian memory mage. All right. Chaga is a psychic mage, so.
It's not out of character. Okay. You make your way to the war room. You see the very large, heavily armored troll standing in the doorway.
I believe we're expected.
Does Trug have a rank?
Yes, Trug does have a rank. He is Major Trug.
He's a major.
Dugan calls him the Smellmaster General.
they refer to him as Major. Normally the term Commandant would be used, but he goes by Major.
He's in command of... Fuck all.
Command to fuck all, yeah.
Major. Chaga salutes and hands Duckin's leash off to one of the privates. Yeah, hold this.
There's three privates there.
Okay.
You hand the leash over to the privates. They look at each other. You're certain there was a quick version of, like, Rochambeau.
Yep.
And then it was basically two of them were stepping back and one guy ended up holding the leash.
Duckin ends up sitting on his shoe.
He's holding the leash. He's looking at his shoe. Okay.
Is the general here?
The general is here, as is Colonel Clark. Do not see Extigan the Blasphemer in this chamber. They are...
I'm going to check the fucking curtains.
It looks like they're amid heated discussion. The last thing that Colonel Clark said is, you're telling me that the first thing they did was retreat and lose the position. That is what your wayfinders did. We should have went in with force. We should have went in with fire. We should have went in with wrath. Taken it all. Burned it down. Colonel, we'll take your opinion under advisement. That is not the way we win this. We will end up having an entire Hobb army rise against us. All the Hobb goblins, the whole planet rise against us if we're not careful.
And a goblin that could traverse many thousands of miles by marching through a hallway. If you don't mind my interruption, Senior Sergeant Legionnaire Chagnon Syndicar Dune the Second reporting for duty, ma'am.
She waves you in, Trunk steps aside, he gives a salute. Wayfinders, please enter.
He just nods to Colonel.
Colonel, steely look, grumpy face. He does nod back.
Okay.
Your missives were somewhat distressing,
yes.
Senior Sergeant Dune.
We would like to share with you some of our memories. I have bound to me a spirit, is friendly, and is not evilly aligned. He has the ability to share memories between two beings. We would like to report on three battles. First was the sack of Phaenfar, where hundreds of goblins poured forth from the iron tower that appeared in the middle of the courtyard without notice within less than 12 hours of our arrival. We killed 300 goblin warriors, one yellow-faced Oni, and two lesser bar guests. The last two creatures I've mentioned have the ability to shape change, and we're masquerading as some of the village elders. The town was affected. Oh, yes, we brought a few heads as samples. these creatures effectively were running the town. Our next skirmish was that evening, as we did tactically retreat from a no-win situation, Colonel. We killed 54 hobgoblin infantry and beast handlers, looking for a place to rest quickly and recover our spells. That morning, we sent the missive to the general, and shortly, not 20 minutes after we sent such missive, a hobgoblin army, supported by goblins, marched down the road to our position. We were but seconds away. We ended up slaying, by Steelrose Squad, 1,358 hob and gob warriors, heavy infantry, wolf riders, and arcane hunters. It was then that we decided to scout the town and found that over 10,000 during that single night's rest had poured through a magical portal / iron tower, some sort of extra-dimensional building. We were able to gather some intelligence from our prisoner here, who has actually used the building and marched through in his elite force of alchemists. Alchemists that could use their powers to melt a church. The church in Phaenfar has been melted, like a candle. We have names of warriors, leaders. We also have missives from the enemy, as they were going to offer some of their troops to one King Parthic and to Prince Ibzeriak. We believe King Parthic to be a troll and Prince Ibzeriak to be a dragon who is
there's another kind of scoff coming from the colonel,
who is apparently a candidate mate for one of their leaders, Nefexi, a alchemist dragon. This one serves Nefexi, There are other leaders by the name of Azersi and Atlantia that are part of the Hobgoblin force. If you'd like me to slow down at all, if I have any questions, perhaps we could share several memories with yourself, General, and Colonel, you seem like a brave man to share the memories of battles. Would you also like to view the battle where we slew over 1,000 goblins?
Maybe he can show you the giants, too.
Oh, yes. We decided that to attack the bridge was unfortunately a no-win situation as storm or cloud giants?
I believe they were cloud, Senior Sergeant.
Thank you, Sergeant. As a group of cloud giants were guarding the bridge, not to mention thousands and thousands of Hobb.
Sounds like hogwash to me.
Well, we'll share our memories with you, and then you can decide, Colonel, with all due respect.
You will not bewitch me. He basically pokes at one of his guards, waves him forward.
Very well. Now, please don't panic. He is green. His name is Lloes, and don't worry, he's on our side. Lloes, would you like to come out of the jar, please, in a non-combative way? Hi! Hey, what happened to your leg?
Okay, so her bow enters her hand extremely quickly, and it lights up with a positive energy.
Are we playing tag? Hello, this gentleman here would like to share memories of the battle. Oh, you want to see my great deeds? Lloes flows through the floor, like kind of walks, but kind of walks down the floor like it stares, and he's like,
a mime.
Yeah. Hi, you're pretty brave, aren't you? Don't worry, this won't hurt a bit, but you'll get to see, well, all of our great deeds. You ready?
He looks back to the colonel. The colonel nods.
Dugan's in his ear.
Lloes will share the minute memory with him of the battle.
Oh, I really like this part.
I was going to stab this goblin in the face.
You hear him say in a somewhat quiet manner, they speak the truth, at least 1,000.
All right. If you could show them what we saw at the village the next day. Right, okay, I have to cast another spell. Don't worry, I got lots of them.
He basically bumps his guard out of the way, and he comes forward for the next one.
Oh, would you like to see the village or the battle? I'll show him the battle. This guy looks like he needs to see a battle. I must remind you that Lloes isn't part of the military. He is technically a necromancer's pet. Lloes will share the battle with the colonel.
It was the sofa, yes?
Oh, yes. A private sofa was up in a tree, bombarding with fireballs, while the rest of us funneled goblins through hell.
And the archer that is... Capra was what was being said?
Yes, Capra is standing to my left here. Horns and all.
Okay, give me a sense motive.
Everyone?
From everyone, yeah.
It's yeah, 30. Yeah. I'm...
Chagga gets out. Yeah, 31.
You know what he wants.
22. Dugan's probably busy.
Oh, Lloes is good.
24.
Okay.
No, he doesn't. Lloes can be locked.
Capper's, like, nursing a split hoof from all the running from a few days before. He has taken notice of the long-ranged destroyers. He he is having thoughts.
Where? Chagga smiles. Lloes, perhaps you could provide the general with the same battle and then the intelligence from the village, basically interrupting Lloes with not sharing the intelligence from the village with the colonel. Since we've... he doesn't add, but he thinks, since we've made a believer of him. And... Oh, you're the general. Oh, okay.
I am the general. Her bow still has like a glowing holy light to it.
You wanna? Is she pointing it at him or?
She's holding it. She doesn't have an arrow drawn.
Okay.
You see Trug waving a hand in Lloes's direction. Is Lloes evil?
Lloes is not. He's true neutral.
Okay. Trug nods. The general then accepts the spell. She's still holding
sorry,
onto
chaotic
her
neutral. Yeah.
They weren't looking for that.
So he just kind of, like, in a friendly way, puts his hand on the general's shoulder, the opposite shoulder from where the positive energy bow, and we'll share the battle and then share the scouting of the village.
Okay.
All the while smiling with his perfect teeth and 26 charisma.
Yeah, senior sergeant here, we could share the thoughts of the prisoners walk through the tower.
It's more like, I know the spell, Dassod, he calls you Kev, but it's, you didn't get images, did you?
No, but his walk through the, if we can use that to get the, the details of the tower and shit.
All right, well, we could share the interrogation, but it is 10 minutes as opposed to a minute.
Yeah.
Just your report will do. They can question him all day long if they want.
No, I didn't write a report, Adam. Do you want me to, I never wrote a report. I never rolled for that.
Okay. Give me a, how are you writing your report?
Diplomacy, so it's nice and organized and makes sense.
Okay. I was hoping you were going to say, in the blood of my enemies!
That would be an intimidate.
Promote me or else.
Promote me or else.
24. I have synergy from bluff, intimidate.
Chagga would have helped you write your report. And 26. Dee Dee would have also helped because she was posing the questions. So.
Okay, 26, 28.
Ducking.
Oh, ducking with the checking of the... This is like a 50-50, you realize.
Spelling. Check the spelling.
Love duck.
Wert means I before E, except after C.
Duckin's got plus 3 profession soldier duck. AIDS. Catching.
30.
Duckin lets you know that there's no U in that word and it's a silent H.
He's just tapping on it. Okay. All right, so you get a DC 30 on your report from the interrogation. You provide a copy to the general?
Yep.
Okay. Good work.
Lloes, if you don't mind. Yeah, I'll go back in the jar. He just gives a wink to the old man. He looks crusty and...
Oh, you know who we could have done? Is given pictures of the people that Grackle saw to Dee Dee. Images, and then she could have drawn. Again, but who are the important people?
The...
Right.
You... Apparently, in your assessment, the term necromancer and necromancer's pet was taken somewhat liberally. I thought it was a skeleton. she notes. She doesn't bring it up any further than that.
Chagga smiles, blushes a little bit, and his eyes go to the floor. Like, he knows what he's being chased by.
I can't be eating a cookie.
Yeah, exactly.
What are your feelings on this matter?
Oh, here's the panicked remarks from the fort commander at Fort Servius, who is aware that there are 10,000 goblins just down the road from where he's stationed. I imagine these orders are to reinforce. I don't know who they go to you, I guess.
she'll take them.
Yep.
She actually motions for you to put them on the table.
Okay. Chagga puts them down. Yep. As for my thoughts on the matter, given that
there.
These creatures are coming from likely 5 or 6 spots all over the Vankeshi territories, or perhaps even all over Volcanica, it means their entire army could be in one place at once. So, a military victory would require a very large army on our behalf that would be met by, well, potentially their entire force. They, of course, can't instantaneously march people through the tower, but they could do so very quickly. It means that we need to take this artifact away from them. Which likely need an army to do.
Yes.
The 10,000 are probably 30,000 by now.
We could take their allies away from them. This king troll and another dragon are probably not the sort of thing we want joining these goblins.
Flies over to Chaga's ear and whispers, they also don't have to worry about supply lines.
Oh, yes, their supply line is the tower. I imagine such a thing would be quite welcome in the hands of the Imperium. If this is an artifact type power, artifacts are difficult to destroy. So taking it might be better. However, come to think of it, there was some mention of some key, right? He turns to his sergeants. Now, I don't know if the key is the way you operate the tower, but there's a key that acts like an artifact something. Chaga's realizing that it was Exegan that mentioned it.
You just hear in your ear.
They were referring to an iron key in the village, looking for the iron key to...
Yes.
I believe it was the tower, but we're not sure.
Yes.
An iron key.
Now, if this iron key does lead to Acheron, which is the most foul place where goblins go after they die, that might be a very interesting way of funneling all sorts of nasty soldiers from beyond the grave. he does the woo-hoo to Colonel Clerk.
Damnable arcanists and their meddling. He's...
Unleashing hell through this gate would mean, well, I don't know, game over? Like, tip the board over and say goodbye to the Vankeshi territories? Or worse, say goodbye
probably to... Probably this Volcanica.
Yeah, Foundry would certainly suffer.
This is unacceptable, says the Colonel.
Well, yes, we must do something about it.
Take some time to bolster our lines. We will need to bring them in green.
Hit and run is the thing that the Steelrose Squad might be able to do for us. We gave them pause, 1,000 soldiers wiped off the map. I don't know, Colonel, if you sent 1,000 soldiers up a road and they all died, all of them, I'm sure you'd pause. I'm on the verge of learning teleport myself. Once I do,
I might be able to bring three of us, four with Lloes here, into a position of, well, to hit and run, to annoy the enemy, to confound them, to get more prisoners and more intelligence. I'm not saying we have enough power to take this iron hole, but we can definitely make their lives miserable. But who am I? I am a mere lowly senior sergeant.
Lowly and pathetic.
Oh yes, quite pathetic.
And infinitely fat.
Well, not infinite, but I am...
But with a great personality, sir!
Thank you.
Yeah, he's such a nice... You should see his cooking, too. Oh, he's such a... Was it failed blueberries with the pancakes and the syrup with the powdered sugar on top? Yeah, the little bit of cream.
Just don't stand downhill after a barbecue. Sorry, General.
This will take time to plan and process. You said that you'd be learning teleport. Yes?
Colonel? Yeah, yes. If I could speak to a few wizards about, you know, the theories behind it, it might be a bit more reassuring before I start jaunting my very large form around the weave. Basically, Chaga's asking for an arcane trainer.
I need a trainer.
As for the others, a short break after slaughtering those goblins might be... Well, we've been running for 4 days straight.
Rest, recover. Did you discover any artifacts in your time?
We have some paltry magic items that we will hand over to the assessors.
So there's 8 members of your squad, says the colonel.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, including Jex and Sulfur, and then Lloes makes 10. So 9 and some pets.
Yet you can only teleport 3 plus 1 pet.
Yes.
I can hide in a bag.
There are ways for us to increase those numbers, but I am not a powerful enough wizard to teleport us all, not without a great amount of magical help or learning. Not something that will happen immediately, General. Aspirational.
I'll be right back, guys. Sorry.
You hear him whisper, Dugan. You were just listening, and you were like a little bit closer than maybe you should have been. That he says something about sounds somewhat inefficient.
The colonel?
The colonel, yeah. Okay.
He has designs on our fucking kick-ass guys. Fuck that! Fuck that! So, Sulfur and goddamn Capra are the keys to victory. We get attacked by an army. The two of them hold them off while we run away.
They blow up the army. Is there a big mob? You blow them up. Is there somebody with a funny hat? Capra shoots them. Okay. Take your rest. Make a list of what you need. We will need to take action and consult. And then we'll need to find that damnable arcanist.
Okay, Chagga provides a list. I already have the values of the items that he's requesting. We may not get all these things, but effectively we want to become Team Fireball. We're asking for a scroll of Fireball, caster level 10, any sort of necklace of Fireballs to replace the one that Dugan lost, 3 wands of Cure Light Wounds, a page of Spell Knowledge with Fireball on it, a rod of Lesser Empower spell because goddamn fireballs. A wand of fireball, because we got a bunch of low-level like sorcerer types that can do it, yep. And a staff of fire. The value of that is well less than the 62 grand that we have coming in from just the magical gear we picked up. I haven't added the stuff we picked up today. So, like, I think Chagga is willing to spend money that we get in order to requisition some of this junk. I don't know, Mark, what do you think?
No, it's worthwhile. Like, wands of fireball will go far in this group.
Well, it's okay. Just the nature of the enemy that we're fighting, right?
Yeah. So. Yeah, large groups, absolutely.
It's your portable mortar slash artillery slash hand grenade. It's like all the war stuff.
Yep.
All right. Mark, you are working on Saturday.
I am, yes.
It's good to have a job. It's good to make a living. Congratulations. is there any RP encounter or sort of character development thing that you would like to have during the downtime? Because basically we're going to roll from this into downtime, and we'll sort out the purchasing as part of downtime activities and interacting with the goods caravan and the reinforcements. And
yeah.
Since you're not going to be there, let's have a quick figure out of what you want to work with, or if there's anything that you're looking for.
No, he just gets into fucking trouble. And
So Dugan is getting into trouble.
Yeah.
What type of trouble is Dugan getting into?
Oh, he's getting into the Colonel Clark shit.
Okay, so you're tormenting Colonel Clark.
And he's trying to figure out, like, what's this guy's plan here? What the hell is he so interested in our guys for?
All right, so you're spying on Colonel Clark.
Spying on Colonel Clark.
And trying to potentially interrupt his machinations on personal glory.
Yes, and Mort's just... Yeah, I don't know. You want me to train? I'll train. All right, fine. You want me to hit something? I'll hit something. All right.
Mort is actually a really good soldier.
Yes, he no questions asked.
Doesn't mind being dirty.
Doesn't mind getting dirty. Doesn't mind killing. Okay, boom. No questions asked.
All right. Okay. So. Please give me a. Stealth check and describe how would you go about tormenting the colonel or spying on the colonel.
He would wait for the colonel. Okay, well, post training or pre training?
Assume it's kind of parallel to training.
All right,
our timelines are a little bit compressed. So
all right, so I will. Just give you the ninth level version. Okay.
Well, you can use your 10th level. You have a 10th level character. Use your 10th level roll.
All right. I think it's only up by one anyway. Size. Yeah. It only goes up by one. So, with invisibility and moving around, as one would expect, the stealth roll. My rolls tonight are stellar, but still a 51.
All right, Ed, you're diminutive, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Did you have a alarm spell? Because it doesn't work for me.
you're correct. It does not work. Okay. You, in your sneaking, find that he is writing up a set of orders. He's basically setting up an attempt to commandeer or enlist Private Sulfur. He actually has a proper name written down, Private Cecil Fur of the Imperial Foreign Legion, and Sergeant Capra Rathorn. And he writes it very Rathorn. It's not even close.
Okay.
His Rathorn is very much a Rathorn. He is looking to get them transferred on special assignment into the Order of the Imperium. And he is basically putting this sort of in a sealed tube off to be sent as a formal commission.
Okay. He wants to unseal the tube.
Okay.
He puts a different bit of parchment in there.
Okay.
And he wants to reseal the tube.
Okay.
And send it off to its original.
All right. What does the new parchment say?
Well, let's put it this way. HR will not be happy with the drawing Dugan put in there.
All right. Give me a either a disabled device or a sleight of hand or a linguistics check?
We'll go with a... Ooh, I actually don't know which one's better right now. Disabled device or sleight of hand? Because I just got a big skill boost at 10th, so...
He's very smart. You got a plus one inter or something?
Just a sec.
Oh, never mind. All of your skill focuses double.
Skill, yeah, all the skill focuses jack everything up. Yeah, yeah, so.
Ten's a good level for those.
Oh, yeah. And Jim's got a few... few skill focus. All right. 10th level. So his disabled device is plus 40 freaking 2.
All right.
And that definitely outweighs his sleight of hand. So we'll go with...
Okay. So I'm going to need two rolls, one for unsealing and one for resealing. And the lower of the two will be the DC for somebody to notice that it's been tampered with.
All right. So...
No. Seal off really well.
And 48.
Okay. That's still a pretty goddamn good roll for manipulating. Okay, so you've manipulated these orders in a way where it doesn't appear to be caught. And give me one more stealth check.
I'm just going to double check. Yeah, it's just plus one for the stealth. 64.
Okay, so you were able to do this while the colonel was...
like a meeting or whatever.
It was a little bit later at night, and the colonel himself, being an older gentleman, was having issues with the plumbing.
Ah, okay, sure. Gives Dugan some ideas. Maybe I should do some prunes and see what that does to the old man. But that's for another time.
All right. So you're able to at least delay, if not stop, a particularly challenging discussion happening.
Yeah.
I guess the only other question is, do you inform anyone else, or is this just between Dugan and the wall?
It's between Dugan and the wall. Some of those guys can't keep a secret.
You wanted to what? Oh. Promotion.
No capra, fuck you. all right, perfect. Okay, so you are able to get trainers to help you in your training. In some cases, it is you're being trained by multiple lower level trainers acting in concert. And we will go through the downtime activities, as well as some RP encounters for the next session. What I would like from Marty and from Ahmed are basically some quick descriptions of goals for during this period, so that I can do some prep.
I think most of it is, to be honest, after we sell our goods, hopefully. We could leave our goods behind to be sold while we're not there.
Yep.
And requisition as much of that fire stuff as we can before getting ready to go out on our mission. Like, I don't think we're taking a prolonged, we're taking the season off.
No, this is why I was saying that. Assume this is happening during your training time, because basically at the end of your training time is be when we're...
Yeah, so none of my characters are doing anything, like, beyond training.
Okay.
Training time is 10 days. You can double the cost for 5. So we could actually train in 5 days.
Okay.
If we have the trainers to do that. The requisitioning of the goods, and then we will basically pony up with the people that owe us money later on. Like 60 grand minus the 40 grand of stuff that we have leaves us with 20 grand. 20 grand divided by almost 10 people. It's not enough to do anything with.
Right. Right. It's just, yep. You'll leave some floating accounts. I know Ahmed has some things that he needs to do. Basically he's getting, we'll cover that next session, Ahmed, but
sure.
If you could prepare what was needed there.
I'm just going to roll for hit points right now. So that's done. So Mort gets another 10.
Awesome. Big old beat stick with big old party.
And 5 for Dugan. Okay, I do have one question for you. When we did the training, Mort took endurance again, because Marty said if you already have endurance, you could retrain it.
Yep.
So will he have time to retrain? I can't remember how long it takes to retrain the feet offhand.
5 days, isn't it?
So I don't know if everyone will have a trainer. So I think like it'll be between 5 and 10 days downtime.
Okay.
I'm okay with just spend the money and it gets retrained in that chunk.
Okay. I will do that then.
Considering you had two chunks of training to get there, I have no qualms with that.
Marty, right, I just wanted to make sure it was okay.
With that as a.
Yep.
Yep. All
right. Cool.
Nice.
So spring, 10th, week of spring, we return to Fort Manius, basically on that road for 4 days.
9 hit die.
And then we train in downtime for 10.
Here.
Yep.
1d10, 1d10. This is Grackle. All right. And that's out. No ones.
No ones.
Fuck!
No ones. I know the feels.
Alright, plus 6.
What's funny is the no once thing actually comes back from 3.5 when wizards had a d4.
Oh yeah.
I remember rolling a hit points for my wizard where it's like 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. It's like, god damn it, no ones, just keep rolling the die. Alright. Let's calculate up some XP, and then it's just those activities. And if there's nothing particular you're looking for, Marty, then it would be. And I think I've got for Ahmed. I know what.
You already know what I want to do.
God is looking for. Is there anything that Grackle
that's,
is?
Grackle's. That's what Grackle's looking for.
That's what Grackle's looking for. Is there anything that Dassod?
Dassod is.
I divvied some of the treasure already. Dee Dee got the vest of tools because she had an open vest slot and she actually has craft skills. Dassod got the spectacles that help with
ballistics, nice.
And spotting forgeries and that sort of thing.
Nice.
Cecilfer got the fire burns cloak, where if he takes fire damage, he could immediate action turn invisible.
He can immediate action turn himself invisible?
Well, there's an illusion of him turning into a pile of fiery bones. And effectively, he's invisible. Thought that was neat on him. Everyone else had cloak slots taken. So, and Chagga took the ring of mind shielding. If that's all right, guys, he had another ring slot. No getting to Chaga's mind. Stay out.
All right.
Other than maybe collecting some samples of tissue for people. But I'm not really engaging. It's just, Dassod's fine just hanging around.
All right. So this.
And then the wish list is the top of the gear and treasure. Everything else we put in front of people for review. Like, we don't care that they're reviewing plus one and plus two gear.
Yeah, there's no. Nothing of the things that you put forward for review. Did you put forward the Ring of Mind Shielding for review?
Yep.
Okay. They took some extra notes and scribbles about the Ring of Mind Shielding. Fine. They don't take it. They just inspect it. They write stuff down.
There were some things that weren't described in concrete values, like 2 bags of coin, 2 bandoliers of potions, and 2 poison arrows. Like, I don't know what those are. I'm assuming they take the poison away.
They. Do you want the poison?
Does anyone have poison use in our group?
Mort might, but he doesn't poison anything.
Dassod's got poison. He's got poisons.
Why would I poison anything when it just goes to mush?
They basically ask if they do you have use for this?
No, that's fine. You can have it. But the bandoliers of potions and bags of coin, we need to know what those are.
Do you know where they came from?
I think the alchemists.
Early on.
They've been early on. Give me a second. I think I know what those are.
This would have been, I think, in the village.
Yeah.
On the Barghest, maybe?
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. There's a...
Dugan, do you want the holy symbol of Mother's Mercy, stabilize 3 per day, bless once per day, and death watch?
What is the slot?
It's a good question. I think
it's a holy symbol. Like you hold it.
Is it a command?
Yeah, I could still hit things. Like I could use the holy symbol to hit things. Yes, I will take that.
Okay, and it's a command word to activate, right?
Yep.
All right. Yeah.
Okay. All right. I'll put that on your sheet under your slot list.
All right. Cool. Thanks.
Death Watch might be interesting for you, like, because you don't knowledge.
No, I don't.
All right. I'll remove that.
The bandoliers of potions. There was two of them, correct? There were two potions. One potion of speak with plants in each. One potion of invisibility in each, and one potion of cure moderate wounds in each.
Oh, those bastards are talking to plants.
Actually, yeah.
What level spell is that?
I don't think it's that high. It's like two? Second, maybe?
No? Nothing from the DM? No. Speak. Our DM's a plant. He's turned into a cactus.
Yeah. It's fourth, third, or second, okay, depending.
That's a fifth level spell. All right, we'll keep those. Who wants to be the plant talker in the group?
Dassod.
You want to talk
Dassod
to plants?
Dassod wants to talk to plants?
Yeah, he's got a good bluff.
I don't think you have to bluff the plants. They just kind of give you planty knowledge.
They're going on your character sheet.
Linguistics.
Remember that you have it.
Okay.
The two potions of invisibility. Who needs invisibility?
Grackle cannot cast it.
Yeah, Grackle.
Okay. I'll just add that to the one you already have. And then cure moderate wounds.
Anybody who gets in the front.
Dugan will take that. He can shove that down someone's throat.
Sure. Including his own.
And if it comes to that.
You've got one. No, you've got three. Cool. Yeah, you guys good with just blasting through downtime to go fight some more mm-hmm. goblins?
Yep.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
That's a cool token for Zogul Ahmed. I just pretty awesome.
Oh, have you got a new token for him?
Yeah.
Oh, do you have leadership this level or next?
I got it at eighth, but I don't get him till, because he's an eighth level character, right?
Yeah.
Zogul's eighth, so you don't get him till 10. So you get him this level.
Oh, yeah. Cool. I get him this level. Yeah.
That is a pimp token. Let me drag that into
the
screen while waiting for. Boop. Nice. I wonder if we're gonna see split the party at a command level happening. Look at Adam smile. As we read the DM's face, we're like, that's what he's going to do. I know you.
So the thing is, we're getting a little bit late for that, because if you have teleport, then all you have to do is like leave at different times and you just teleport to the same place. When you're
sure, we'll go that way. Right. That's funny.
Anyway, internet's tight.
Okay, we need a name for tonight's game and a little bit of XP, I guess. What are we going to call tonight?
Strutting.
Fortnite.
Oh.
But with a K. Oh. Fort Knight.
Well done.
Yeah, we'll do that. Okay. That was so cringy. You almost got to do it. Yep.
Yeah, exactly. He comes over saying, well, the Oni disappeared, so I thought we could get our own Oni. Oh, that Oni is bad news. The one that's in the puddle.
Fox, oh, frig, yeah. Oh,
Fox has got a great idea. Yeah, your follower shows up. He fucked up.
Yeah, she woke up.
She's got us. I got
it. Hey, goblins.
Fuck it, I came here.
That's funny.
How bad is it? I joined the army. That's how bad it is.
came here to fight hobgoblins because fuck that noise.
What was the advanced? There's an advanced rogue talent you guys were talking about.
Improved evasion?
Yeah, improved evasion.
Improved evasion because of all the reflex saves or take damage from the troops.
That's... Opportunist is also good. If you're in melee with someone and someone else hits him, you get an attack of opportunity on him.
Hunters.
Once.
Once a round?
Yeah, once a round.
Damn.
All right, some XP, which I think Adam can do offline, given that he's burping on burping on the internet. All right, this was super fun. We'll see you folks on Saturday for episode 8 of season 2 of Grimstone Chronicles.
1600 XP.
1600, okay.
There we go. Oh.
Get it. Get it.
Adam, can we requisition like crafters to craft something?
Maybe email him.
Oh shit, he's not here. Damn it. All right. I'd like to get Grackle to craft the strength plus two strength into his glove so that he can wear the fucking dex belt.
Mark that down on the downtime sheet. I've already entered our training and the fact that we've 10 days of downtime. Yeah. So
I don't have the money for it. I don't know if we can requisition that. I'll put it down and see if we can do it.
So
or
you
not.
Can attempt to requisition things, but it's a requisition,
which means they'll say no. Unless it's vital to the mission. That's
gonna be we're gonna get Dassod to ask for that one.
Dee Dee could eventually do crafting for you to move things around, but you need the money.
And the thing about requisition is it's not yours.
Mm. Or does it just make sense? See, I've already got a belt of strength. Does it make sense to put add a plus two dex?
All right, I'm going to bed because this is making me mad.
Yep.
Yeah.
Good game, Adam. See you on Saturday. Okay.
Night, bye bye.
For those watching on YouTube, thanks for support, and for those hanging out with us tonight in the chat, it's good to see you folks here. And as always, we hope that you enjoy this as much as we do. Peace. Have a good night.
See you.
Bye, guys. Peace. Thank you.